Welcome back. In the last episode, we got the boathouse taken down, moved over, and then we were starting to put the boathouse back up. However, we did have to adjust the post sides to compensate for the differences in ground level. So this is where we take off here. Enjoy.
Yeah, so we started off with a big 3-ton floor jack and just chained the post to it. But as the post went up, the jack went under, and that kind of created a problem. And we could only get a little bit each time. So we used some good old Yankee ingenuity, and we built a post lifter. The post that needed to be cut and made shorter, that's an easy fix. Removing wood is always much easier than adding. So the posts that needed to be extended, we wanted to make sure that, you know, they were strong because there's a joint in the middle. So what we ended up doing was adding a piece at the bottom and then basically encasing that in a piece of 2x6 and 2x8 so that it made, I don't know, what we called a boot. So it was bigger at the bottom, and the inner post went inside of it, and everything was screwed and bolted together. So I think that boot is probably the strongest part of the post. I'm not really worried about that joint coming apart. And it also gave us a better landing spot for the bottom of the post, a little more surface area, which, you know, doesn't hurt.
We ran into a little trouble with the cable.
Yes.
The original boathouse, we had a straight run to two very strong trees.
Almost a straight run, but yeah, a lot nicer angles to play with.
Yeah.
Yeah, this one ended up being pretty vicious. So initially, we had a maple tree at one end of the boathouse, and there was a big spruce tree that was off to the side a little bit for the other end of the boathouse, and there was another big spruce tree over here. And we brought the cable from this tree to this tree with a little Y over here just to kind of eek the end of the cable over and get it in line where we wanted. So the angles were, none of them were very severe. They're all very gentle. And so we could yank the cable really tight, and all three trees were just huge. So there's not really much of an issue of pulling on them too hard. When we spun the boathouse, we could still use one, the big maple tree at the anchor point, but the other end we had two maple trees to work with, and one was pretty spindly and the other's kind of rotten. So that, yeah, a little less than ideal. And then the other issue is that we had to string a cable between those two trees and then connect the center of that cable back to the maple.
So it made kind of a triangle.
It made like a T at the end. And to get those cables tight enough that the end of the boathouse would be far enough over, it was just way too much pressure on the cable, way too much pressure on the trees. It was just not going to be good. It was not going to work.
So what did we decide?
I mean, the only logical solution that we could come up with was to get a mast. So we grabbed the chainsaw and went mast hunting in the forest. And we found a pine tree that was, I don't know, yay big at the base and didn't have many branches and was nice and straight. And we cut that down and ended up standing that up for the end of the boathouse. And then we guide that down to the bases of those two maple trees. So even though the one tree's rotten and the one tree's spindly, down at the bottom they're still really strong. And then we ended up burying a dead man in the hayfield.
Should we strip the bark off this thing and give it a coat of duck varnish and make it look like a real mast at the end of the boathouse?
Have an actual mast before we make the boat. A little bit more work than we were expecting, huh?
Oh, always is, eh? Finish getting the roof up this weekend. We'll definitely get it done this next weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And next weekend, the roof will be on by the end of the weekend. The lofting floor will be done. The workbenches will be done. And the weekend before you go up to the wedding, we can loft.
I can't explain all that. However, I am smart enough to know that grabbing Fenzoil Platinum Synthetic for only $4.99 a quart is a smart deal.
See how close I got?
Very good.
Yeah. When you drive over them, they line up real nicely. I'm a little worried the chain's not strong enough, but you know.
It's not that big.
Let's see. All right, you ready?
Let's do it.
This is what makes a Subaru!
You better not put that in, I'll kill you.
Hey, we got the mast for the boathouse.
I think that'll be nice and straight, strong. Should be able to hold it.
We'll find out.
Our little pine tree was going to act almost exactly like the mast on a boat. We needed something to counteract the pull from the cable which was going to hold the plastic of the roof. For that, we were going to use the pole and stays heading down to the dead man and down to both trees. Since there was going to be a lot of pressure on those and the cables were going to be around the top of the pole, we needed to make sure that it wasn't going to damage it. We used tar and a little bit of canvas in order to protect that area.
All right, we're ready.
So for starters, let's carry it over so it's in line.
Uh-huh.
And then one of us can man the gree-gree and one of us can just start pushing up until we get it up high enough. We got a mast for the boathouse.
This is where being on a farm comes in handy. My great-grandfather loved to put fence posts in concrete, and lots of times he used giant steel pipe as fence posts. So we have a few that got removed at some point kicking around, and we cut the post off. So we have this just ginormous piece of concrete with a big steel pipe in the center. So we use that as the dead man. So on the edge of the hayfield, we dug a deep hole and ran a big fat chain through that pipe through the center of the concrete, rolled that down into the hole, and then backfilled it, and used that as the back anchor for the mast for the boathouse.
What is this, Steve?
This is how my great-grandfather used to make fence posts. So he would put a giant steel pipe in the ground in a big hole and fill it up with concrete. When you gotta move them, it's not fun later. So we moved this at some point and somebody cut the fence post off it. So we're gonna use it for a dead man to help support the mast at the end of our boathouse. So we're gonna bury this on the edge of the hayfield. So we're trying to move it, and since the bottom's tapered, rolling it, it just wants to go in a circle. It's far too heavy to pick up and we need to get it over by the hayfield. There's a lot of obstacles in the way, so we can't drag it with the Subaru. So Alex and I are gonna use the steel bar and some teamwork, and we're gonna just flip it end for end until we get it over there. You ready?
Ready.
I believe it's your move, sir.
Well, I dug the majority of the grave for our dead man. Steve started setting up the stays. Stays are the cables that run from the top of the mast all the way down to either the boat or whatever it's anchored in. Those are what will counteract whatever weight is pulling on it, be it sails or, in this case, the boathouse roof.
All right, so we dug our hole and we're gonna put in what's called a dead man. So this is that big chunk of concrete with the pipe through it. We attached this nice light length of chain there that we had kicking around. Tucked that underneath. Dug the hole. I'm gonna roll it into the hole, hopefully the chain lands on the right side. We're gonna stick the chain up out of the ground, and then we're gonna attach it to the top of our boathouse mast, and this should provide the counterbalance for the roof.
All
right. And once this is in the hole and buried, it should take quite a bit of force to pull it back out, in theory.
In theory.
All right, I got it, you ready?
Ready.
Go for it.
We need to get it sitting right in the hole. Right now it's a little crooked.
Okay, you ready? Now I want to lift with my back, right? Take my legs completely out of it.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, all right. One, two, three.
Down for a little bit. There we go.
That's pretty good.
Pretty good.
I think that'll work. That'll do, pig. That will do.
All right.
Now we put the dirt back. We have the boathouse mast and the boathouse mooring.
He doesn't let me use the real tools.
He always hurts himself.
This is it.
Let's do it.
Okay. So just pull that, try to pull in line with this cable as much as you can. And I think we just pull it as tight as we can get.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
All right, Steve, why do we have these blocks in here?
So the trees have the outer bark, and then just under that bark is a layer that's called the cambium, and that's actually the only living part of the tree. And then underneath that is what they call the heartwood, which is all, you know, dead wood, more or less. So you can think of the cambium as these straws that run up and down the tree, and they bring nutrients from the leaves to the roots and from the roots to the leaves and so on and so forth. Now, if you put anything around the tree, a rope, a chain, a cable, anything like that, as the tree grows, it expands, and that stops it from expanding. And what happens is you end up pinching off those straws, and the tree will try to go around them, but the tree doesn't know how to disconnect, move around the object, and reconnect. It just keeps trying to squeeze. So unless that object surrounding it breaks, it'll eventually basically suffocate the tree, and it'll kill it. So this tree, although it's not a great one, it's still young and it's growing. So we'll put these blocks on it. And that way the tree, all of this will be unaffected over the next couple years. Where the blocks are, it will definitely affect the tree, and it's still not great for the tree. But we'll be able to take the cable off and knock these blocks off and not have any real damage to the tree, which is good. The other tree is really big and really old and really rotten. So I don't think we're gonna block that one. We'll just leave the cable around it, and if the tree grows into the cable, that tree's probably gonna come down before it's really an issue, before that cable can kill it. So we're not gonna worry about that one so much. And since that tree's so much bigger, it's not gonna put on as much girth as this smaller tree will. It's your botany lesson for the day.
We already had a nightmare of an experience putting the plastic up the first time. This time, it was a little bit easier, but still not quite easy. We started out by stringing up the cable a little bit, getting it set up so that we were ready to pull it tight. We then draped the plastic over the middle of it, and we pulled the entire line up with the plastic on it so that it would already be set up in the middle of the line.
Thank you.
Once that was done, we had a static line, which means that it doesn't stretch, stretched from the tree all the way to the top of the mast. Steve then, with some climbing gear and of course being safe, climbed out onto this and started unfolding the plastic and draping it out along the entire length of the line. Once we had the plastic all laid out and the ropes underneath it, we used the ropes to get the line up and out to the edges of the boathouse. With the ropes attached to the boathouse, we could then take the plastic and stretch it tight. This was by far not an easy task. The cable is not as tight as it used to be, and this took us a long, long time to do.
You're tired, huh?
Tired of this, too.
What?
Tired of this, too.
Yeah.
I'm ready to be done with this roof.
Oh, my God. I mean, we were done with it all over a month ago.
Yeah.
And do it all over again.
And it looked better before.
Yeah, it looked better. And it was harder the second time. But.
Yeah, well, we can cinch it down and next storm see what does.
Yeah, we're going to keep playing with it.
If anything starts pooling, we can play with it.
But it should work. I don't think it's going to pull too badly. The snow scares me more.
Yeah, me too. That's what I'm worried about.
Yeah, so we'll snug the ropes, time off, take a little more tension out of the ridge line, and then I think we're done with the building for now.
That'd be good.
As we mentioned earlier, I had a wedding to attend to, and with all the work that we had to do, we didn't manage to start lofting before I left. But I went off for the weekend, and we were planning on lofting when I get back. We had a wedding this weekend, so not working on the boat. So right now we're up in Camden, but checking out the boats before we have to go to the wedding. We're gonna do a quick hike, get cleaned up, and have some fun. Forgot to shave before I left, so we're gonna go out to the lake and we're gonna shave me and get ready for the wedding. Here we are. Give me a quick shave. Anything?
I don't think so.
Am I bleeding?
No. Ta-da!
Almost ready for the wedding.
The end result.
Alright, this is it. Transformation. Ready for the wedding. Out of courtesy, I didn't want to video any of the wedding. However, I do have to say, it was one hell of a good time. Congratulations, Sam and Jillian. As I already drove up to Maine, I figured I'd take advantage of it, head up to my mom's, spend some quality time with her in the woods, and with some cute puppies. After the short stay at my mom's, I stopped in Portland, Maine to cut the drive to Massachusetts in half and make it more manageable.
Just spend a couple hours in the coffee shop working on videos. And it's such a nice day out here. I really needed a break, so taking a little walk around Back Bay, well, around the Eastern Prom. I'm gonna head up to a friend's house, gonna make some banh mi, and head out to the beach. See if we can spend a good day outside.
Strange fairy villages and quality time with friends was a perfect way to round out the weekend. Now, it's time to get to lofting. Lofting the plans of the boat means drawing them out full size. The reason it's called lofting is because back in the day, the loft was the only place large enough to actually be able to do this. The process involves making a floor large enough to fit the entire size of the boat on there. You then draw a grid out, and you plot some points, and then you mark the curves. All of this you'll get to see in the next episode.
up, puppet? What'd you do if I smeared some of that on your lens, huh?
Mm. Yeah. Bird.
my friend that works at the porthole.
Oops. Did not mean to turn this on.